Hi guys, I'm making the last video. I'm putting that first so that I can just explain what has happened with all of this build. As you know, I wanted to make this documentary where I ordered a drift car, Formula's drift spec drift car built in underground garage in Norway, and I wanted to show you guys the whole process of me ordering it and driving to Norway and picking it up and all of that. That will come after this first part of the video. I will show you as much as I did, but not everything went the way that I wanted it. So I got the car yesterday, and it is 3.5 months late. So the builder broke every single delivery date on this car. The shipping alone took about a month to ship it here, and as per the contract, I was supposed to pick the car up in Norway, and I was in Norway. I drove up there with my RV and my trailer in tow, 1600 kilometers, ferry and all that good stuff, and went to his shop to pick it up as agreed, and they were not finished, and I waited up there 9 days until the car was almost finished. And then the builder forgot to put oil in the engine, drove the car around on the parking lot, put it on a trailer, and then we went off to tuning. But at that point, the engine was already damaged, and I pretty much had enough at that point in time, and I then went home. Now, to get the car delivered at the date that I wanted, I think it was the 18th of March, the builder asked me to pay 10% extra on top of what I was already paying, which I agreed to. Now, since he broke that date and had me wait 14 days or something like that, and then I drove to Norway and my car was still not finished, of course I said I'm not gonna pay those 10%. And let's just say he got so sad about that and wanted a little bit of money for at least trying to make it, which in a business world is fucking ridiculous. But anyways, I decided, okay, stop your whining. Here, I'll give you 5%. So he got those 5%. And I gave him a month to finish the car and deliver the car to me here at my address, race ready. Now, after that, it took 2.5 months before I finally have the car here. And it's not exactly race ready. Well, the design of the car is the wrap is not finished. It's complete bullshit, and they have also acknowledged that, and they will supposedly pay me money back. We will have to see about that. I just want to show you a couple of them. I mean, it's complete crap job. The design of the back doesn't look good. It's just all black, and I mean, there are tons of issues. The wrap job is just really, really poor. The other thing that it was even more crazy, this is a 100,000 plus euro drift car built. I paid more than 100,000 to have this car built. Right off the shipping trailer, it was not a trailer, like a big truck that moves cars, the car was running on 5 cylinders. So I got my race-ready car, and it was running on 5 cylinders. Now, why is it running on 5 cylinders? Well, when your wiring is so shitty that the wires come out of the plugs, and I've only tested 2 of them, you can see here, I've not even tested those. When your wiring is that shitty, well, then you are gonna have problems. So, as you can probably hear on my voice and how I'm making this video now, I am definitely not a happy camper. The whole process with underground garage in Norway has been subpar, unprofessional. It's a one-man show in a little piece of shit garage in a industrial area, and he should definitely not take on builds of this caliber. Now, what I want to do with this initial video is I want to just tell my story, what has happened, so that if anyone else is thinking about having them build a car for them, they know what they will be getting, you know? That's kind of the point of this video so that the truth can come out, you could say, so everyone knows. And oh yeah, did I forget to say that when he then broke the engine by not putting oil in it, again, you know, really sad, and that was a bullshit, I again, as the gentleman that I am, stepped up and said, you know what, I'm gonna help you. Here's another 3,800 euros so that you can get the engine repaired or buy a new one for me and do it properly, you know? I mean, every step of the way, I have fulfilled all of my duties. I've sent money exactly as specified on time. I've been in Norway to pick up my car as per the contract, but it has been complete bullshit. Now, I've missed DHB in Denmark. If I wanted to go to Gardebilen in Sweden, that would have been missed. In Norway, that would have been missed. Nürburgring Drift Cup 1, 2 and 3, I missed those. And a lot of practice drift days at Papenburg and at Wiese. And I also missed 2 times Drift Camp Brunski. So pretty much my season is just toast. Everything is just fucked up. And now that I got my car, finally, I can then now start by having the car rewrapped. I can have some of the stuff painted that was not painted the way I asked for. And I can then start to fix this engine stuff. And I'm sure, I'm really sure that a lot of other stuff is gonna turn up when small stuff like this already is there, you know? I just had the car lifted. There's definitely needs to be painted in the bottom of the car. Many of the places where it's been welded doesn't even have primer. There's tons of holes here and there that wasn't plugged, so smoke will definitely come in the cabin. I also have to fix all of that. You know, I'm not a picky guy, but when you pay 100,000 plus for something, it should be a ready-to-race car. It should come off the trailer, everything should function, and I should be ready just to go to a race. That is not what I got, that is what I paid for. And that is why I'm making this first part of my video, these fucking 7-8 minutes of rambling. So guys, I'm sorry that I had to tell all of this, that's not what I wanted. I'm not out to destroy people, but in this case, I think the world needs to know what has gone on up there in Norway, in underground garage. Now, there's another thing that I want to say, that is, I want to say thank you to all of David's friends that helped him when I was there, staying up all night, helping him, trying to get the car finished. I want to thank you all, because you did a great job. You were true friends, and I hope that David is going to pay you some cash also, because I paid him a lot of cash, and supposedly those 10% was so that he could pay you guys to help him. So I hope all of you got some cash also. What more to say? I want to say also thank you so much to Stian from Moonshine Racing for borrowing their wheel machine, and he helping me putting on all the tires on the rims. That was super. Thank you so much. That's more or less it. I just want to say thank you to the guys up there that really helped. And now, after all of this bullshit and explaining, I will then show you the videos that I made leaving for Norway for picking up the cars and so and so and so. And that's about it. Hopefully, after this bullshit video, the next videos of this car is either being me fixing something, or it will be finally the car out and drifting. Maybe a little mad burnout or some shit in my parking spot outside of my garage at some point. So guys, stay tuned, and yeah, stay strong, man. Stay drifting. Bye. Here I am, somewhere in Germany. About, I don't know, I've been driving about 3 hours now. I forgot to make a video in home, so like the first video of this trip, but this will be the first then. So I'm right, some gas station, getting some diesel for a car. A little, what is it, Burger King stuff, meal, whatever. And I still have about 1500 kilometers to go. It's time to pick up the new drift car and get it tuned and go on the test track and test it out. So I'm hoping this video is gonna be really good and have a lot of action. But first we have to go to Denmark and visit my mom, and when that's finished we will have to go on to Norway. So it's gonna be many small clips in this documentary or whatever you call it, I don't know, video log or what you call it. Anyways, I'm just trying to make a longer video of many small videos so you can kind of see the whole trip. And yeah, that's it. For those who don't care about the whole trip, you can just skip forward to the part where we're on the racetrack. So I mean, for those of you that wants to see everything, you can. For those who you don't, that don't want it, can skip ahead. And for those of you who don't give a fuck, you can stop now. So yeah, that's it. I'll see you later, guys. Bye. Aboard the ship, there's water all around. It's not as fast as I thought. I thought it was kind of a catamaran ship, you know, that would race up on two fins and really power over the sea, but I guess it's not. It's not that fast, I think. So, anyways, I'm at the back of the ship, just getting some air. I have arrived at the underground garage here in Norway. Beautiful location. Well, Norway is pretty beautiful. An old industrial complex next to the railroad tracks. And I parked my car, got some power, getting some water, taking a shower, and then I think this day for me it's just over. But the guys are at working crazy on the car. It's not finished yet, but it will be. Monday's tuning, Tuesday's testing. So down there she is, the beast. I'll just let the guys work. And this shop does mostly JDM, as you see when you go around the corner. Two Supras, another Toyota. Oh yeah. And we're just next to the train tracks here. So I'm here in Norway. I just put on 10 tires on my new rims. Underground Garage had a friend who had a little garage where I could go and borrow a wheel machine. And this here is what they call a little garage. You can see here what and this here is not a commercial garage. This is just for fun. This is 10 guys just having their own race cars and having a garage together. Now, I mean, this is every boy's wet dream, you know. And it's like 400-500 horsepower, 500-600 horsepower, 600 horsepower. It's crazy, everything, you know. Here's a Toyota Supra, also building some new engine stuff. And the guy who has his car here is not here. He told me that he's in Dubai doing drifting there. And then they have a big bus and stuff. So, I mean, the guys in Norway, they really know how to do that shit, you know. And here's a park just outside here. And I borrowed that wheel machine and put on the 10 tires on my new rims, so I have some spares when we go testing, hopefully tomorrow or day after. We are a little bit late. I just wanted to give you this update on how the Norwegian Vikings play. Just a small update on the video that I did yesterday in the garage when I was showing the different cars. I think the first car I showed was a black Audi, also a big turbo. I probably said it was
400, 500 or 600 horsepower, and it was a race car. I spoke with the owner of the car today, actually. The information I gave was not right. It's an 800 horsepower all-wheel drive Audi, and it's a daily driver. It's for the road. It has a number plate, so that is fucking awesome. 800 horsepower all-wheel drive on the road. I love it. So yeah, that's just a little information for you guys. If you thought it wasn't crazy enough, that garage, it's super. I like it.
Finally time for tuning. We just get the car out. It's a little bit too low, but we don't have time to adjust it. So but now we go to tuning, and then we can work out the box after. So hopefully the next video will be tuning. We have arrived, got the car off. The car is really, really, really low, but this we will fix later. But we got it off and connected it to the dyno. The guy's getting ready. All the guys been working all night, haven't slept, to get the car ready. There were some problems with some, I don't know, some water lines, or some of the lines was leaking, and I don't know. Apparently they had to do a lot of work to get it all sorted out. But anyways, we're here, and it's tuning time. So I'm crossing my fingers that everything will go good today, and then it's back to the underground garage, and then I think the guys are gonna sleep a little bit before they continue work. Probably not today, but I don't know exactly what is going to happen. So see if I can make some videos when it's on the dyno, or at least some photos.
It hurts if it's in the body.
This is one of those videos that I don't want to make, but I have to make. Tuning world went really good. We make about 800 newton meters, 600 rear wheel horsepower. That's about 700 horsepower. So that was really good. Cooling systems was fantastic. It runs so cool and so nice. Pretty much everything worked on the dyno. So the last thing to do to check if this engine is really good was to cut the oil filter and have a look. And when we cut the oil filter up, we could see there was a lot of metal flakes in the oil filter. A lot of small debris. Well, not small debris, but kind of like gold dust, aluminium dust. So that means that the engine is damaged. So let me explain what happened and why I'm sitting in my RV in the video that you're watching and explaining that I have to go home and all of this stuff. Now, the builder, David Rieber from Underground Garage, when he was finished with the car, very, very late, he drove it around the area where his shop is and revved it hard to get the engine hot because it was not running right. And drove it on my trailer and stuff like that. And then when we came to the tuning shop, to the dyno shop,
they discovered that there was no oil on the car. Now, David Reber, he hadn't put any oil on the car. So by that point, the engine is pretty much toast. I mean, no oil on an engine would kill it. And no oil in the turbo bearings will also kill those bearings. And I think earlier in the video, later in the video, you will see that I now have some issues with the turbo leaking and some blue smoke and stuff. Anyways, to get back to the point, so it was decided that if engine damaged or not, we might as well just put some oil in the engine and dyno it and just see how it goes, if it's completely broken, little bit broken, or what's going on. So we dynoed the car, and after the dyno actually went fine, and the car, the engine didn't show that it was damaged, but after the dyno, the oil filter was cut, and in the oil filter there was a lot of metal flakes and whatever. I explained that in the video you're seeing right now. Now, I just wanted to point this out, because at the time that this happened, I told David that I was not gonna tell everybody about him not putting oil on the car, because I didn't think it was necessary to tell everybody, because, I mean, it could destroy him as a builder. And I said to him, if you just, I gave him 3,800 euros to help him fix the engine. I gave him that extra for free as a gift from me. And I said to him, as you will also hear in the video where I'm sitting in my car, that he should build it finished, deliver it to my house, race ready, and he had 1 month to do it. Now, of course, he didn't do all of that. It took many months and whatever. Anyways, so if anyone is questioning that what I'm saying right now is a lie or is not true, I will tell you this. We were at KRB Trading in Norway. The owner is named Kai. He was there. He saw that there was no oil in the engine. He can confirm it. Also present there was Stian from from Moonshine Racing. He was also there. He can also confirm that what I'm saying is true. There was no oil in the car. There was also one of David's friends, a little skinny guy, nice guy. It does a lot of electric work for for David. He also was there, and he can also confirm that there was no engine, that there was no oil in the engine. So that's just a little information I wanted to add. That's about it. See you guys. We have to rebuild the engine, everything, check everything. So my builder here have to take it all apart and rebuild everything and then continue the build. Now I have no more time to stay in Norway. My mom is sick and I need to go visit her and stay with her and also see my family. So I'm leaving Norway tomorrow, and my builder here will then finish the car, test the car, retune the car if needed, make everything needed on the car so that when I get it on a truck or in a container or whatever they want to, how they're gonna ship it to me, it's a ready to race car. So yeah, so the next video, guys, is gonna be not right now, it's probably gonna take a little bit of time so that you can see that it's not just so easy to build your dream drift car, and it takes a lot of work and patience and so on. Here at the harbor in Larvik in Norway, so on my way home, or not home, on my way to Denmark to visit mom again, the race car is left at the garage. They have to do more work. I think I explained that in the last video, that there was some engine damage and stuff. So here it comes, Super Speed 2. So I think 3.5 hours or something like that from Larvik, Norway to Denmark, Hirtshals in the top of Denmark, and then another 3 hours drive. Oh, for sure, yeah, I have my trailer on. So for sure, another 3 hours drive to to the place where my mom is in Denmark, and then we will see. I will stay there some time before I go back home in Germany. So, a quick update on the new drift car build. It should be coming next week, and I also sold my M3 drift car. So the new owner of it's coming to pick it up here in 10 minutes or something like that. He got it at a really, really good price. I mean, I pretty much had to sell it. I don't have the space for it, so I sold it cheap. And he's getting a really good car. He's getting a car, and all the wheels, there are four more wheels than this, and he's getting all of that ready to drift. So hopefully the next video will be the new drift car parked here in my garage next week. Yep, and next week the car didn't come. It's probably not a surprise to anyone yet by now. And it also didn't come the next week, and the next week, and the next week. About 4 weeks or something like that. Finally, the day came where the car arrived on a truck that can carry cars. I don't even know what the name is. Piss pouring rain. Had to have my brother-in-law come out and help to take the car down. Must really hard, and we had to put wood here and there to get it over the bumps and everything. Just not a good experience getting a brand new race car that way. Anyways, at least I got it. But then get the car off the trailer, my 105,000 euro built, and as you can hear, it's not running on all cylinders, you know. And I go and I check all the plugs. And how do you check it? You pull them all out, and when you find one that doesn't say anything when you pull it out, then you know that it's not firing. Not even the Kolben is firing, you know? What the fuck is that? There's some tired of this. So yeah, this is nice to get your new car, and it doesn't even run off the trailer. Man, what the fuck, David? Yeah, that's a really bullshit. So I then had to start investigate on my race ready car. Why is it running on five cylinders? Well, if your plug connectors, when the wires are not secure in there, and not only in that one, but also in that one, and I haven't even tested the others, when these things are not secure, then you are not running on all cylinders. And I really think that's a very sucky way to get a new race car. So, but I'll make some more videos later for you guys, so you can see more of the car. So I sat down and I wrote an email to the builder, David Rieber from Underground Garage, telling him about the issues with the car. At this point, there were issues with the steering, there was issues with the wrap, there was issues with the fire, the wiring of the car, and yeah, stuff like that. So I sent him an email, and this is the reply I got. So this is the newest development. Have a read on this one. I recommend you to stop the video and then read first what I wrote, and then read the reply. Seems that someone is now not gonna pay me back what I'm owed for things that doesn't work and is broken on the car. This is just a small list. Now, let me show you these things here on the car. Let me show you. Yeah, what a fucking idiot. No, so I just wanted to prove to all you guys watching that I'm not crazy and telling the truth. So, is that paint that has come off the car, yes or no, when the black film on the back of the car was removed? And you can, I mean, it's a clear as day. Someone didn't paint this the right way. The paint came off with the film, you know? How much more clear than that? You think quality of the job? Look, this is the quality of the film job, you know?
quality. This is what 105,000 gives you. You know, quality of film job. The wrap job. You know, this is the quality. That's what you're saying in your email, that there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with this. You know, there's nothing wrong with all of that. That's what you're saying. That's what you deliver from Underground Garage. You know, that's the parts. That's the things that I want money back for. You know, cause I'm gonna have it redone. Look like that, you know, and why not race the car and also show the leaking wreck? Brand new car, never drove it, not even once. Let's see if I can get this rag out. Yeah, there we go. So I dried it off, so there's not so much leaking right now because I dried it all off, but you can clearly see it's leaking. You can clearly see the oil on the rack. This is the oil. It's a leaking rack, you know. And I don't know, for those of you who are Supra, who knows a lot about Supra, this is the power steering pump, sits up there. This solenoid thing, that is from an Aristo. That doesn't fit for this application. This Aristo uses a completely different system with a solenoid that limits your how easy it is to turn based on how fast you're going with currents and blah blah whatever the fuck it is. That pump doesn't work on this application, you know. So I asked for a new pump and I asked for a new rack. Why wouldn't I? It's 105,000 built, you know. That is what you get. I mean, that's so ridiculous. So I'm just documenting these things that he's now also not gonna pay. So we, of course, by this point now have broken off all communication, and I am making these videos now together with all the other ones, making it into one big fuck you Underground Garage and fuck you David Rieber video for all of you guys to see. And yeah, maybe I'll meet him one day. You never know, if I'm in Norway, maybe we'll come see you. Nah? So until then. Another issue that I didn't even show in the email is over the diff in the underneath and the car, there's unprotected bodywork, a little bit of rust. It wasn't painted, and I didn't even mention it in the email. I just went ahead and cleaned it all up and resprayed it and sealed it and made it look nice. I just wanted to show you these pictures I took before I fixed it. So getting ready to go and test the car for the first time. Been working on it for 5 days, trying to solve all the issues, but there are still issues left. But I need to go test it as much as I can so I can find out what the rest of the issues is with the car. So here I am, ready for leaving. I'm here at Solder Paddock Drift School to test the car for the first time. I did 5 minutes here on the parking lot, and I can already feel, as I said and as I suspected, that there's something definitely wrong with the steering of the car. I already ordered, because I knew it already, I already ordered a new rack and a new pump. Hopefully I can get some testing in here, even though it's gonna be shit, but so that, you know, I can find out what are the rest of the issues with the car. So that's kind of what my day is gonna be like. So it's the Solder, and down here is a big parking spot, and I think there's only eight cars that eight guys have brought their own cars, so it's gonna be really good. Other than that, it's kind of school,
what do you call it, drift school, where they can rent cars and just learn it. But we in a different group, so there's only 8 cars in my group, so it's gonna be okay. Tons of problems with the steering. I'm trying to adjust the pressure on a little screw out there in the steering, but it's not really working. As I said before to the builder, that there's something wrong with the steering, you know, but they don't listen. So just a little video of some stupids playing around with the car, but can't really drift it because the steering is fucked. Yeah, that's how it is. The rack is fucked and the pump is fucked. So I ordered a new pump and rack already. So anyways, a little video for you. Exactly sure why. Oh, they're so heavy. Jesus.
newly built, first time I tested.
Yeah.
There's something wrong with my steering.
The steering.
You can feel, try turn my wheel, try turn it. There's something wrong. It have resistance and it flutters. I'm trying to adjust, there's a pressure screw that I can adjust.
Yeah.
But there's something wrong. I need to have a new rack and a new pump.
Yeah.
That's how it is.
But you can play with it.
Yeah, I'm trying to see if I have eating issues, if I have other issues, yeah. So that I can fix it all.
I have a question for you.
Yeah.
When you come back later.
When I come back?
No. When you go back on the track later.
Yeah.
A few minutes,
yeah?
Yeah. Can you take this guy for a passenger ride?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah?
Yeah, for sure.
Smoking from the turbo, and we could see that it had an oil leak. How bad it was, I will first find out at a later point when I come home. But here's a video someone took of it.
I think we need like a flashlight or something just to show.
No, just to show this, just the smoke. Yeah, you can see it a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure, you can see it.
I done a few skids in the new drift car, and as I said earlier, the steering is complete bullshit in this car. I ordered a new rack and I ordered a new pump, and hopefully that will solve the issues. It's definitely completely fucked up. Everyone could see it. Everyone loves the car, and I'm telling everyone who built it, and everyone is laughing when they see the steering issues. And also, everyone is concerned that my car caught catching on fire because it smokes so fucking much. And why does it do that? Because you have a massive return line, oil feed from turbo return line. There's a big leak there. And I remember it smoked also on the dyno a little bit, and everybody just said, oh, it's gonna be oil in the turbo boot, that it's gonna burn off, blah blah, whatever the fuck, you know. That was also not fixed. But you know, that's what you get if you get something built in underground garage. That is the quality of the stuff. 5 days I've been working on the car to just make it ready to come here. I drove last night here, stayed until the morning in my RV, slept here, so I was ready for a full day. I have a car full of fuel, full of tires, I'm ready to race, and I did, I don't know, an hour here, and I have to now go back home because of these issues that I already knew was there. So yeah, anyways, that's gotta be the last video. Maybe I make a video in my shop once I fixed all the issues, and put also in this the road to Formula Drift build video documentary thing that I'm making. Anyways, that's it for now, and have fun, guys.
So do you guys remember the email from earlier in this movie, you know, about the wrap job not being so bad and all of that stuff. Let's have a look what happened when I washed the car.
I gave the car its first wash by hand. And remember, this is the folia job or the wrap job that Mr. David Rieber from Underground Garage said is a super job and it's okay and it's good enough and he doesn't want to pay back money for that wrap job because it's okay. First time I wash it by hand. I wash it by hand. By hand. By hand. This car was washed. Not in a machine or something, by hand. You know, I think the result speaks for themselves, don't they? You know? I mean, come on. Come on. That's too ridiculous. At least I am laughing. I'm having a laugh. Because, you know, it's so ridiculous by this time, everything that what you can do other than just laugh.
So you want more proof of the lying that's going on? Okay, no problem. This is Facebook, Underground Garage Facebook page. And if you look at this video, you can also see here, where is it? Oh, here, it's Kevin. Kevin posted this video, Underground Garage, they reshared it. And they write up here that the car is working good. Now that is my video. This is my friend Kevin who made this post. So let's go to Kevin's page. Here you are. Here you have Kevin's page. He's also a drifter. Nürburgring Drift Cup. He has been on podium. He's been drifting in the UK, been on podium. So he's a known drifter, a known person. So let's go down. So Kevin, he was at my event at Solder, where I was testing the car, and he just posted this post. Now, I also replied to the post, and as you can see, I am clearly writing that everything was not okay, and the car was not good, and there were some problems. Now, if you then go to my Facebook page, you can then, this is my Facebook page, you can then see here exactly. This is the same video, also from Kevin. And here's the description of actually what went on that day and that it didn't work and the car wasn't good. And it was leaking oil in the turbo, that it was puffing blue smoke, that the steering is completely bullshit. And after 1.5 hours of trying to fix it, I had to go home. So I missed the whole event. You know, I spent 2 days, one day getting there, one day to go home. It was a complete disaster. Now, Kevin, which we were just on his page, back to Kevin. Kevin can also confirm that my steering was bullshit and that it was leaking oil and all of that stuff. Let's go back to my Facebook page. And this is also a video on my Facebook page that Kevin made for me.
When you like a flashlight or something, just to show.
No, just to show this, the smoke. Yeah, you can see it a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah, sure, you can see it.
That is smoke you seen now on a video of a video, on a car that's not running. That's a stopped car. That's just not on. That's how much smoke it is. So I mean, pretty much things speaks for itself by now. I just wanted to share this with you if anyone still has any doubt about my integrity and about if what I say is true or not. You know, it's everything is 100% true that what I say, and I have the proof to show it. You can ask Kevin or you can ask any of the 50 people that was on that event if my car was working good and everything was okay. And you can ask them what time that I loaded my car and went home. Everyone can tell that after 1.5 hours, I had to put my tail between my legs, put my car on the trailer and drive home. You know, 105,000 euro drift car. And I was the only one that couldn't finish the event. I had to go home. So, yeah, anyways, I just wanted to share this also. Bye, guys. After the first drift event, after the first testing and with the leaking turbo, It looks to me like I have to take the whole manifold off and everything. So all of this must come out off to have a look at what's going on with this turbo. I'm gonna take it apart and inspect it all, and yeah, some videos. I'm gonna make more small clips as I go. So I'm getting all the bolts and the hoses off down below. I'm starting upstairs now to take off stuff. I just took off this pipe and have a look inside the pipe. There's oil inside the pipe. This is that's not right. So I'm thinking in here. Yeah, it's there's oil in here, you know. So if there's also oil in here, that means that I'm not guaranteeing because I don't know, but I'm betting that this turbo was not rebuilt after the issue with running with no oil, and the whole fucking thing inside, the bearings or seals or whatever, it's leaking inside and it's leaking here too. That's what I think is going on. Anyways, we will see. I have to take it apart, then I can ask the builder if he will own up and will have the turbo rebuilt. If not, I'll have to do it myself, or I send it to someone, to Comp Germany or Comp Norway or whatever, who can rebuild it. And if that all fails, I will fucking get a precision turbo and I will put that on. At least that is something I know about. But let's see. I didn't even see that before. This is the other end of it, if you can see. It's also oil here, you know, and inside it's also kind of oily. So oil has been leaking from inside the turbo and from the cold side of the turbo, and then in and to the intercooler and stuff. Finally, I have off this whole stuff. Here's the turbo. You can see how much oil is in here, and you can clearly see here all the oil here. So the oil comes from inside here, the shaft runs out here and would then leak out onto the return pipe. And we thought that it was the return pipe that was leaking. I don't think so. I think it was from here running down there, and then also of course leaking inside the hot area of the turbo, making blue smoke in the exhaust. So this is the whole issue. So this turbo has to be rebuilt. We will see if the builder, he will rebuild it, not himself, but if he will pay for it. I think the turbo came from KRB Trading, that's Kai, and I want him to rebuild it. If the builder won't pay, I will pay Kai myself. That is not a problem. But anyways, that was a little bit more information. So this bearing, or journal bearing that I think that it is, rides in this here. This here is groovy now. This thing is super thin, bluish in color, was burnt when the engine didn't have oil, of course. And then there are more issues along in here. You can see how much oil is in this whole thing here. That's crazy. I'm not sure. I don't know if it's supposed to be like that, but it's definitely not supposed to come out from this part of the shaft. And that is also kind of bluish, and this just looks funky. Let me take it apart here a little bit more. And we can see the cup full with some shit. And then we can see this here. You can see how it looks. Nah, that's about it. So I sent an email to Underground Garage David Rieber, telling him about he needs to give me a new turbo. This turbo is complete bullshit. I sent pictures and everything, and he has, of course, just replied with some bullshit that I'm a moron and that there's no warranty on blah blah and whatever. You know, I've shown in the video to all of you guys already that the turbo was already smoking on the dyno, and
I mean, I never drove the car. I mean, it haven't done one race even. So this is what you get if you deal with underground garage, guys. So spread the word, make sure that other people don't get in the same situation as me. I don't really give a fuck about the money. I'm just gonna buy a new turbo and put that on together with the rack and all the other stuff, you know, and go make some mad skits and have fun. But not everyone is as lucky as me. So I would really hate to see some guy who's been saving for many, many years to build his dream race car having to deal with bullshit like this. So please share, like, subscribe, tell others about it. And yeah, that's about it, guys. See you.
So I want to thank everybody for watching this documentary movie, and I'm gonna finish it now. This was an hour of your time if you watched it all. This is what I had to say, and this is what happened to my drift car build. I will surely fix the turbo stuff and I'll get the car back drifting. So hopefully in the future it will be fun, smoky, happy videos from here on out. So bye guys, and have fun, and stay drifting and all that good stuff. Bye bye.